Greets peeps, it's Tony the Hero of France here. No, the Hero of the Franks here. So we've time warped into the future by some margin. Our truce with Spain has died down. In the intervening period, they had a war with Gascony to try to take back their territory and lost it. But didn't seem to. Gascony didn't seem to do much with that loss. They controlled most of Greater Spain and a good chunk of the Spanish Italy. Thanks to the help of their allies being the guys that we fought before, Great Britain and the Papal State. So I don't know what happened exactly, but it's definitely weakened Spain. Spain is still having issues with corruption. They're a bit ahead of us on tech, but we don't care. They hate us, and we need to attack them quick before they can start a coalition on us. So, we've just created the claim that we need, one of the claims that we did earlier timed out, the claim on Abruzos. So, we've now claimed that. Our plan remains, we're going to take these territories along here, and we've got our armies in place and have had them in place for some time before I realized that I didn't have that core. So we're going to move over there. He's going to take that. This guy will fight anyone that comes in on us. That guy will fight anyone who comes in on us. He's designed for combat a bit more than this chap, who's very much more about sieging. And we've got this army here to help the French muck about down in this area here. They're a lot more susceptible now. With this fort gone, we'll have access to various of their tiles in here, and I think we're only two sieges from taking their capital. So that being Castilla and then Madrid. So in 7 days time, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, we attack. We're bringing in Savoy and Denmark. Austria's busy fighting the Ottomans, which I really like because I'm certain it's sapping their manpower. In fact, let's have a look at that before we do. Austria's manpower is zero. That's exactly what we need, because after we do Spain, after we knock Spain out of potentially causing a coalition against us, we begin on Austria, and we begin on Austria by attacking Alsace. They have some allies, but we don't care. We're going to... they're not allies we care about. Great Britain probably won't accept the declaration. Oh, they will. Okay, I thought I'd beaten them up enough that they wouldn't. But that changes my plans a little bit. I may not declare there, I may declare somewhere else. Both of these I need. Utrecht is probably the better option if we declare on them. In fact, we may chain these wars. If we're in a war with an ally, Savoy, and then we declare on someone else who is under the control of the Emperor of the Holy Roman Emperor Empire. It's easier to show you. If I were to declare war now, Austria would join and they would bring in all of their allies, including Savoy. There are other allies I don't really care about. Saxony could be a bit of a problem, but everyone else there is not very tough. They're all one province miners. In fact, Friesland is one as well. Okay, I might get my last core there, and then get claims on both of those and take both of those in the war. Take that, and that in the war. Because I need those three. That will break my alliance with Austria, and I'll be free to begin working against them openly. And it couldn't be a better time than after they've just had a war with the Ottomans. But they would ordinarily call in Savoy, because Savoy is one of their allies, and this is a defensive war that I would be forcing them into, and Savoy would likely accept. The same reason they won't join me in attacking is because Savoy is allied to the Holy Roman Empire Emperor, who would join in. However, if Savoy's already in a war, and they would jump in and join on Savoy's on Austria's side, hence on Utrecht's side. However, if they're already in a war with us, they can't accept that offer. So this is a solid plan. We go to war with these guys, we bring Savoy and Denmark with us, then we attack Utrecht. That causes us to fight Utrecht, Austria and Saxony and some other clowns, Friesland, and I think Ulm maybe it was. But so what? That's not a big deal, we can handle that. This game is getting exciting, and this is where it all kicks off. The place that we want is Abruzos, and we bring in Savoy and Denmark. Our Portugal are allied to Spain, that's a bit of a shame. Austria are busy, that's cool, we don't want to bring them in anyway. Oldenburg and France are coming with me because they're my boys. And let's have a look at Wallachia. Wallachia. Cool, they're only allied with us in Spain. We can set them as co-belligerent, and Wallachia are allied with, they're allied with Venice and the Knights. Oh, and Nuremberg and Venice again. Nah, we won't co-belligerent them. We'll let Denmark take out Wallachia. I'm not even sure where they are, to be honest. I thought they were over here somewhere. Wallachia, Wallachia, Wallachia. There. Wallachia. So, you know, if they do cause us any trouble, I'm not too worried. So, let's declare war. We'll co-belligerent Portugal. I don't know what we'll take from them. I don't think there's much we can take from them. But, we're also Florida, Spanish Canada, West Indies, and whatever colonies Portugal have got will be involved, but they won't have navies to get enough troops here to be of concern to us. Boom, here we go. That one doesn't go there, he goes straight there. That one, how much? No, he'll take attrition there. 34, that's 46. No, he can. No, he can't go there. Within that zone of control. Should matter. That guy's doing his job anyway. This guy, I was going to have him run straight in. I think that's fine. I don't think they'll have anything that can handle an army of this size with a leader like that. But we'll come down here and have a look with our ships anyway. Yeah, coalition's happening again, not surprising. We've been a very naughty boys. In the coalition, Augsburg and Utrecht. Who's Augsburg? That guy. Not much bothered. And actually, coalition war could cause us trouble, but we'll try and skirt around that. There's ways and means. Which of these guys are harder to spy on? Build a spy network at 0.86. God damn. Build a spy network at 1.38. Okay. They'll be the guys that we declare war on. I think they've got allies, though. Utrecht, the reason they're so hard to spy on is because they've got espionage ideas, one of which reduces the ability of enemy spies or of spy work against them. But there's got to be some way to do it. I don't know what, but there's got to be some way to do it. See, they're not allied with anyone either, so I can't attack one of their allies to attack them, unfortunately. I'll work something out, I'm sure. Okay, here come the coalition numbers. He's quite happily sieging away. That guy can, no he can't, he'll take attrition. Oh, hang on, yes he will. If you have a look, that province has that marker, supply limit 33, but because he's got a leader who has maneuver rating of 2, the actual weight of the army in that square is only 32. He's got maneuver of 2, reducing the supply limit of the army by 1. So we can move him there and he won't take attrition, is the long and short of it. You just siege stuff out, please, France. I think I've got this side of things covered. I've bumped up our army to have 15 artillery, because I think that's the level 3 requirement. Whoa! Oh, they didn't even have their things turned on. Their things were ungarrisoned. Oh, this is the perfect plan. That siege should be short as well, because rather than 2,000, the siege is already halfway through. This is brilliant. Oh, someone attacked me. Yeah, I didn't think they'd have anything to really threaten me. Although I am annoyed that I lost some men in that battle. Yeah, we lost 2,000 men, that sucks. 3,000, wasn't it? 2,900, 3,000. That's way more than it should have been if I were paying attention. But I was more concerned about getting attacked over here in the main area, in the main sphere of combat. That guy's died. We want admin points. That guy costs us 17 per month. The bourgeois can give us a minister. It'll put them up to 85. That's okay. I think I can. He's the 17, he's the 8. So he costs half as much. Less than half. God, he costs a third as much? A quarter as much? And his monthly cost is half as well. So he'll be our man. Thank you very much. We're back to 7, because 5 was 4. It was awful. What was the thing I wanted to do? That's right, we've got to head that off before it. We'll put it at 84 by removing one of the territories they control. They don't need to sell fish. Actually, they don't need to sell grain either. That's clergy. Whoops. Blue is the... that's close. That could have been annoying. Blue, we need to take away something of theirs with low. That one is inefficient. Because there's way more tax on that one, I had an event before which gave an extra tax tick to there, there, and there. So I want to, I've been meaning to take these off them anyway because it's inefficient. That tax is getting reduced by a quarter because of the autonomy that the burghers put on it, add to it, so it's not worth them having these. That one will be more advantageous to me. That one will keep them over 40. drops them down to 82. Cool. Once they're a little bit happier, we'll take that one off them as well. Great. Perfect, perfect. How's the siege going? 21. Cool. How's the siege going? 42. Great. I'm going to zoom out. I normally keep a closer eye on things, but I want to make sure we're not sneak attacked by anyone. Oops. I like little Friesland there, actually successfully doing that siege. Siege of Toledo is over, not at all. I'm tempted to go break that siege, just so I don't have to do it later. Ah, too late. Actually, we can still have a fight with them on that. Oh, it's woods. No, I didn't think it was woods. We'll change this up so we don't take attrition, and we have a backup force to help us if we need. I'm tempted to, how strong is this army by itself? They handily beat that force that attacked them before. Maybe I'll send this guy over to fight that guy? Well, we've got allies on that side. We'll focus over here. We'll stay here. And yes, so I didn't notice, but our diptych has maxed out. I've been waiting a long time to take this. Do I do it, or do I spend the diptych? Do I do it now, or do I wait till it's cheaper? It's only money. We can get more. We're gonna take a bunch off. Hey, we've got a free merchant too. We're going to take a bunch of money off Spain anyway. We'll try to. I imagine they're probably broke after that last war they just did. Global trade originated in London, which we control. Cool. That doesn't spawn until 1650, another 19 years. And there's no presence in Burgundy. To make this spawn within our land, we need to have all of the different factory types. We don't have all of the factory types at present. We are missing a whole bunch, so I'm trying to quickly get those built with the money that I have in the background, so to increase our chances of being the spawn site for it. But yes, let's spend this cursed Diplo. Yep, cool, whatever, doesn't affect me. Neither does any of that. Well, it's nice being ahead of time for once in again in these techs. We get that again, that trade advantage and that corruption reduction. I'm happy with that. This one we can fill up to 1200. That one we can buy. We're actually really close to getting that one as well. Maybe we do get it. I don't know. We'll see how we go. There's I've already spent all of the Diplo that I can think of spending on culture conversions. That was the main thing that I was spending it on, thinking that that would be helpful. I'm going to join on to that guy. Oops. They've joined on to me because I was headed the same direction as them. Let's go fight those guys and go fight those guys. Stay with me, France. Don't split up, please. Ah, curses. That's okay. We wanted to go that way and take that fort anyway. We will bring this around there. That's not a good way for you to go now. Where are they headed? They're headed to Asturias. Is it quicker to go there? I think it probably is. Given that they're most of the way to that point, rather than starting again and going click, 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 I think that would be quicker. I'm not certain. I'm tempted to find out. No, I don't care. caught them there, but I missed the opportunity. Oh well, that's what happens. We'll just go take this Portuguese fort. Oh yes, we've got our spare merchant. I forgot about him. Is that siege still going? Yeah, 78. Typical. Let's work out what to do with our free merchant. Our trade, we've got 50%, 54% of the trade power there. 24 there. 17 there. Ah, we have a whole bunch of trade power in Venice since we took Venice. Let's collect from there. Interesting to see how much it is. There's 6 value there. By my count, it should be at least 3, but it may be more. And it will only increase as we break our way into Austria. Ah, that was a Pulos. Cool. The only other fort they have is down there. Let's go with them in case there's people to fight. There are. Oh, they're trying to unsiege their capital. See about that, matey. Hurry up. Be faster. I guess we do have allied troops who aren't very strong with us. I suppose. Oh, damn it. I hate those bottlenecks. Okay, so I'm not certain if we've spoken about this before. Those red X's are normally little dotty lines. Little dotty lines like you can see there. When you've got little dotty lines, you can move between them. When you've got red X's, it means they're being navally blocked by someone, namely this C-bomb. By 2 transport ships are somehow blocking us. Yeah, okay, bro. Frustrating, yes. Part of the game, I guess so. I think they altered how the mechanics work. The mechanics of blocking seaports at some point. It's been a while, I can't remember, but as I say, I very rarely use naval crap because it's just a bit frustrating. Well, no, that's not true. It does help. There's some cool things it does. I've got a naval blockade going on here, which is... No, I haven't. Where is their port? Ah, yes. So, this being a seaport, they would get... a sea fort. A sea... a fort that's edged by the sea. They would get a +2 bonus to their defense if I hadn't put this guy here to blockade. Oh, I can cross. Someone's engaged their... France, engaged their ships. Great work, France. I just want to have a check of something. The coalition that was against me has 4 members. I don't think I can declare on any of these clans. I don't have a spare diplomat. And all of them are doing important things. Except for this guy. All he needed to do was fabricate a claim on Lincolnshire, I think was the one I wanted. No. Gloucestershire? Oxfordshire? Essex, Lincolnshire. Don't care about Yorkshire. Which one's Yorkshire? Yorkshire's that one. That's in a different node, a state altogether. So I need Mercia, 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 Mercia. Hang on, did they have... I thought I saw gold. No, there can't be. No, I'd know about gold in England if there were. Mercia, Mercia, Mercia. Mercia's going to be my next target, obviously. And Essex. Wales is not very developed, typically. Oh, that one's quite well developed. But I think Yorkshire's better developed. Yeah, we'll take that one. Just because there's no point in wasting that stuff. The Siege of Bressigau is over. Cool, bro. You can go there. Diplotech. The reason I'm not going to do this is because I'd rather bank that that money until we're not uneven anymore. Our techs are getting wonky and we'll start paying through the nose for them. And our economy isn't strong enough to handle that. I don't feel like paying constant corruption costs. Actually, there's a chance that being ahead of time reduces corruption enough that it offsets the tech that is off. That's 0.5 at the moment. If I go another tech ahead, does it increase? That's 0.05 rather. Screw it, let's do it. Bam. Actually no. Oh, we're ahead of time. I don't think we'll have anyone to spy off anyway. So, at the moment, there's no corruption. 16, 17, 18, all within 2 of each other. This will unbalance us. Yearly corruption... No, okay. There's the bonus is a one-off bonus. It doesn't double up depending on how far ahead in time you are. Curses! My plan is foiled. But that's okay. We will pay that... whatever it is, 0.41, and then pay more. Oh god, that probably isn't a good idea. Unbalanced research, ahead of time tech, positive stability. Rooting out corruption only does 0.01, but that's going to get higher as we take over the territories that we want to take over. So yeah, we'll see how we go. Hopefully, no, when we take over those territories, we're only taking territory off one of our opponents, so it shouldn't be a problem. They should all be grouped. grouped, so that the when they're not grouped, even if there is a leader there, if they're not grouped together, they won't get the his maneuver advantage. They won't get him protecting them from attrition. But this state is too small anyway. 29, 28, 27, 30. Okay, we're splitting this army up. We want the leader nice and close because he's better at battling than this guy is. 4, 3, 1. No, he's not. 3, 2, 2. Yeah. Anyways, it's better to get him across quicker in case this guy goes on us and somehow gets 50,000 troops enough to make us scared. What's going on over here? Keep besieging. This army's a little bit exposed. We should probably go join up with France, actually. While we can see him wandering across there. Oh, he might catch us. No. We might take a... We might start moving back. We'll likely see him come there and then go on France. At that point, we'll charge in on him. He's not going on France. What a fool. He'd get a woods advantage from attacking France in that spot. Okay, he's coming for this army. We're going to try and double back on him once he comes this way, and we'll go back to that lot. We'll actually put that spare leader on this guy to make him move a bit faster. They joined that army up. The cunning bastards. Okay, we're going to lead them on a merry chase. That's how I plan to outmaneuver this guy and avoid him catching me. This is cool. In the meantime, France is getting a chance to besiege that. Hey, cool. That siege is ended. Let's do another siege there. Oh, what was that diplomat meant to be doing? I was looking for a... That's right, I wanted to see if these guys in the coalition against me, if I have a coalition thing against them. They're all in the Empire, god damn it. They've got a variety of allies. They have a variety of allies. They have a couple of allies. Those aren't big allies though. This is probably the best one to go for. Nuremberg. We can't do anything to attack them. Can we fabricate a claim? No, they're nowhere near us. Do you know what? Maybe we'll let a coalition happen. We'll let Austria protect us in a coalition war. Oh no, because we wanted to do this immediately, didn't we? How can I get into a war with any of those clowns? Have they got a regency, did that say? Oh, regency council, I see. That would be the best way to win this game. If we somehow managed to take the Austrian crown, that would be the best. If they became our junior partner, this game would be over in an instant. We'd just have to, once the emperor is a junior partner, the emperorship moves on to someone else. That would mean that myself and Austria could curb stomp the new emperor, take the things we want, and that would be game done. That's not likely to happen, unfortunately. Habsburgs are pretty good at breeding historically. Not that that's a real mechanic in the game, but We'll keep Austria out of this war. How are their forces looking? They've got 50,000 troops left. That's quite a few. More than I'd be comfortable man fighting. Ah. Our troops wandered straight into theirs. Ah. And their main troop isn't interested in that. Cool. Okay, so, while I was in between wars, I managed to get the 1,200 military points to get these stupid naval ones that I don't care about. What do they do? Make our ships tougher? I don't care. Make our morale better? I don't care. And reduce our naval attrition? Super don't care. But, we can now do our final military idea, which will give us an extra 5 discipline, and we're better at fighting with artillery. So we're better at fighting with infantry, cavalry, and artillery, and we get yearly army tradition growing by itself. Boom, thank you, and thanks very much for that discipline. We are now a top-notch army, we just need to get our technology up. I can make states, can I? Nope, not out of either of those. And I can do building? No, I don't want to do that. I'm going to need that money when the corruption hammer comes down. Group that group. Group those people. There you go, France. That's the way. I think France are going to get attacked, so I'm going to head up to aid them. Nope, Spain decided not to attack them. Damn it, that would have been the perfect spot for it too. That's cool. If we go here, they won't attack us. If we go then we can go here, and we can attack them. I wish France would join us, though. No, that's Highlands. They get a defensive bonus. Siege of Mantua is... Messina is over. I'm going to move all these troops across, and then we're going to attack as a group rather than taking unnecessary casualties. We need to be mindful of our... Wow, we've already lost 20,000 troops in this encounter. Almost 20,000 troops. Just from attrition. When we're making our war deal, I'll actually show you this one time, I promise. Sorry, I meant to time that so they landed at the same time. These guys will get there earlier because they're closer than those guys, but only by one day. And actually, that's a good thing, because if these guys arrived first, they would take that river crossing penalty into battle with them. And these guys, even though they didn't cross... Damn it, these mountains, I didn't realise. So I get a massive terrain... Oh god. That did... because the leader was on that side. He brought the river crossing penalty and the mountains penalty with him. This is a tough damn fight, dude. Spain occupied Burgos. Are they unsieging things? Okay, whatevs, dude. Come and join me, please, France. Burgundy occupied Palermo. That one guy is going to go over and catch their troops. I think maybe we should bring some people with him. Boom! The Spanish army is gone. Oh, yeah, that was our entire army. I got confused for a sec there. Cool. We'll leave those guys there to siege it up. And we will split this army in half and go for a wander up around here. Ah, we've got enough to put our claim on Friesland. Wish they didn't have so many goddamn allies. It's these guys that I'd love to attack. These guys I need to take over as well, but they have no allies. That'd be the perfect place to attack. But when I try to spy on them... Look at the size of that growth. That's not even one spy network point a month. That's going to be 2 years worth of spying to get a claim on the buggers. I should have been doing it the entire time had I planned it out properly. That's okay, this war will take a couple of months at least. What's that? Production efficiency, I don't care. We've improved with Savoy as much as we can. Split this army in half so they don't take attrition. Burgundy occupied Burgos. France, please come with me, dude. What are you up to? I haven't actually started this game. Oops. I haven't actually loaded this game since when I did it the other day. So it's probably lagging a little bit. Or more than a little bit. Get the hell out of the way, dudes. Okay, you keep going up that way. You wait there. We'll let them get a little bit apart from each other so they don't accidentally cross paths and cause themselves an injury. 36, that's enough to house all of those, I believe. Yeah, looks like it. Who else are we at war with? We've taken all of Spain. We're at war with Wallachia. Nope, not worried. Actually, so there is a thing you can do in this game where you can, when someone's at war with someone else, if you can get into that war and vassalize the defender, you take over that war and you get to call in your allies as though it were a defensive war, because at that point you are defending your own subject. That is a really good thing to use, because it means that you end up doing a lot more, you end up getting to bring your allies in, rather than in a defensive way, rather than trying to bring them in an offensive way, when they often won't work and you have to spend favors to do it. Actually, that's a point. I'm not certain if I've ever mentioned favors. Favors are in the diplomacy area. If you look at your allies, you'll see that your trust is 50. That means they trust you pretty much. But favors go from 0 up to I don't know what. Let's have a look at a proper ally, shall we? Go up to 100, I'd imagine. So trust goes up when you do them favors, they do you favors, you work together and you stay at peace. As we'll see with France, for some reason they don't trust us much. It's probably those 20 wars that we had with them. With Savoy, however, we've been pals since almost the beginning of the game, and we owe them 37, they owe us 37 favors for times that we've jumped into wars and helped them. Similarly with Austria, they owe us 48 favors. That's all going to disappear in a puff of smoke very soon, as is their trust, but hey, whatevs, bro. We need that land. Ah, we do want to spy on the Papal State, don't we? Because we want to take Mantua. Dorothy Mantooth is a saint. How much will this cost us? 20, I imagine? Yeah, 20. That's the only... Oh, of course, they've only got three states left. And we've... Hang on, no. We want to put a core on there. That's right, that disappeared on us, didn't it? So ideally we'll get cores on both of those, and at some point in the future I'm certain they'll declare war on us. Oh yeah, go. I'm going to avoid those, and hopefully so are my allies. I really hate when your allies take out enemy rebellions, because they're helping us effectively. We'll stay clear of them so they don't decide to attack us. Oh, well, lucky I've got troops down here. How strange. How the hell do they have troops down here? They must have had like 30 treaties to get through to Spain. At least, oh, I guess perhaps they had a treaty with Ottomans, but I wouldn't imagine so. I'd more reckon that they'd go through Serbia and then Poland. And Poland, they could go all the way up to here. Serbia, then Poland, then Austria. I don't know how they did that. They must have had a treaty with the Ottomans, I guess. Bizarre. Because I'm fairly certain that a landlocked nation won't have ships to funnel their troops about the place. Siege of Castilla La Vella is over. Damn it. That's going to lift that entire siege. Okay, that's going to lift the sieges on. You can see the little progress bar lifting on everything in its... Oh, get in. Okay, perfect. Those rebels are going to occupy it. That'll stop the things from becoming unseaged. And I don't need to do anything about it. Get there quickly. You'll see these reverting back down. Hooray, our sieges stay. They weren't in control for long enough to de-siege all of the provinces that we'd sieged. I'm not going to go over here, I can't see what's going on in Portuguese area, but we're at war with them too. They might charge out and hurt us, and no one likes that. Well, they probably do. I'm not a big fan. Spain's unsieging stuff back there. France has gone to sleep. I've got a feeling that their liberty desire has gone over. No, if that had gone over 50, then I could understand that they might not do any fighting. But I think it's because the game's been running too long. It does feel like it a little bit laggy. How many troops have we got here? Total 1,700. With a maneuver general, a 103 maneuver general. Awesome, dude. You're doing great work. Savoy's here to do some stuff, though. Get some siege on. That's the way. Go siege down Portugal, please. France is alive when someone tries to attack them. I'm annoyed with them now. I don't mind letting them get murdered there. They deserve it. That's right, I can't go on that one because of that fort's area of control. I don't know why I can't go there, though. Oh, I see. I can't go there because I'm in this fort's area of control, zone of control, and I can't go there then there because I'm in that fort's area of control. So I can do this, 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 this. That's exactly what I'll do. I want to make this peace deal last as long as I can, because I don't want Spain bringing in any allies to a coalition while I'm busy doing work on the... Is that mountains? There it is. I don't want Spain joining the coalition against me. That will form after I take their land. And I think they would have done that anyway. We've got Bayer. Now we can go there because we would have been able to go from there to there. I think that's the rule. It's a confusing one. Who can we hand these forts off to? You can pay for them, Denmark. No, oh, I should have put it to Denmark. I should have gone for Savoy. Actually, Sweden never brings troops down. Sweden, you can pay for all this stuff. You bastards. Not really much to say here, guys. It's just siege and repeat. Oh, damn it. I didn't realize we had another idea so soon, or were so close to another idea, because I would not have spent that tech on diplo tech that I don't care about. Would not have spent those monarch points. Okay, let's have a look at our idea groups. Oh, we already have... No, we could have gone for a second diplo group. Poop ants. Oh, well, at least we're inured against the losses that we would... at least we're ahead of time in that tech, so we can afford to lag behind while we do some other techs. Now, the tech that I've been having my eye on for some time was... diplomatic, because it increases our diplo, gives us another diplomat, it's cheaper to reduce war exhaustion, improve relationships is easier, diplo relations, reputation is better, and province war score is reduced. That one there is the primary concern for me. Diplo tech costs reduced, I don't care, and lowered impact on stability from diplo actions. Yep, that's helpful. I don't anticipate doing any... that's kind of hard to explain, but when you declare war on someone without a casus belli, you'll lose stability. There's a bunch of different things that you can do. When you break a truce, you can lose stability, and that limits the amount that you lose. It reduces it by one for each thing. That's not much, though. It's a good way to save admin if you're doing crazy wars, but ideally it's better just to avoid crazy wars. This one here, however, I almost never use, but there's some cool stuff in here. It's easier to create your spy networks, you have cheaper advisors, you have an extra diplomat, I don't know what that trade modifier stuff means, but you notice enemy spies, liberty desire and subjects goes down. So there's a couple of things in here, because that's a concern with France. Cost to fabricate claims goes down, that's choice. That really saves us time when you combine the ease of creating new spy networks with the reduction in cost of creating new spy networks. It's top stuff. Embargo and privateer efficiency, I never use those. Corruption going down, that'd be good. And rebel support efficiency going up, that would also be good. That would be quite tempting to do to Austria later on. They've got a big chunk of Bohemian lands, so we're gonna go for espionage, which is I very rarely use, but that core creation, being able to spam core creation, good, France has woken up. Being able to spam core creation, spam claims rather, is just what we like. Is that occupied? Someone occupy these lands, please? Florida occupied somewhere. What even is that? Oh, because Denmark's been occupying Spanish land over in the New World. Good work, thank you. And someone's unoccupying it. Whatevs. I'm thinking now that we, well, this continues, I'm thinking about our, is that improved already? Our max is that. That seems weird. Oh, we're allied to someone's rival. Ah, Denmark's rivals to both Savoy and Austria. That's okay. Recall, yep. So, were we spying on Utrecht? We were, weren't we? Yep. And it's slowly getting there. It's not as near as quick as I'd like. Do we have a claim on Metz? I don't need that core, but I want it. Yes, we do. So, what else shall we do with our spear? We've got them on side, we've got them on side. These guys are well on side. No, they're not. Because we're allied to two of their rivals. Apparently. What about this? There two. That only goes up by 133. We can change that once we take this war over. We'll leave that happening. Sorry, once we win this war. Actually, I should have done. I could have set my war goals up. This war is just going to trundle on, and it's just a matter of besieging everything. I'll round this video out now, and when we come to the end of the war, or if anything exciting happens, I will be sure to let you know. See you in the future.